Okay, we just want to say that we see the results of our faith, and that's the thing that we always believe in God for, to see the end of our faith. The Bible says that that we become partakers of Christ when we, amen, hold fast to our confidence, steadfast to the end. Amen. That's when we will see the end and the results of our faith, when we hold fast our confidence, steadfast. How many know it means a lot to remain steadfast in your faith? There's a whole lot of things that can come and deter you and to cause you to doubt the ability of God's word, but we know that the word of God is forever settled in heaven. God stands behind his word to perform it. Everybody can say amen.
Amen.
And I think that when we, as the scripture says, the confidence that we have in him, that we can ask anything according to his will. We don't always have to ask, we can decree a thing. And the whatever we ask, the Bible says, the confidence that we have in him, that he heareth us. How many believe that God hears you?
Amen.
When you pray? And this is what being in right standing with God is all about. Job 33:26 is a scripture that assures us that God always responds to our prayers. The confidence that we have in him, that we can ask anything according to his will, and he heareth us. And if we know that he heareth us, then we have the petitions of the things that we desire of him. The moment we pray and release our faith, we have it as far as God is concerned. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. We have it as far as God is concerned. Now when Sister Hill goes out, and sometimes she calls me back and said, you want me to bring you something back to eat? You know, she doesn't want to cook that day. You know? Yeah, she said, do you want me to bring you something back to eat? And I said, yeah, I think I would have dust and so, you know, she gets that, she agrees, and whenever, the moment that she agrees and she gives me her word, she always tells me, she says, if I tell you a rooster dips snuff, you might as well go looking under her wings. His wings. Okay, she always comes up. But that's something that how a person's word can be their mind. How you can actually trust people. You can tell people by their word.
Yes.
You can talk, you can tell a dog by his what, bark, and bird by what, the song. And you can, you know, the chickens by the, you know, when they cluck, 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 cluck. But you can tell a man by his word. How many can say amen? And that goes to show you that God's word does not ever what? Return void. How many can say God's word doesn't ever return void? If I could advise you to do one thing when God speaks, the Bible says his covenant, he will never what? Break. How many believe that God's word is completely reliable? How many ever remember going back throughout history, looking all through history of those thousands and thousands of years, have God's word ever proven to be unreliable? How many ever remember one case in which God's word returned void of power? Even you never, because his word is what? Forever settled in heaven. The Bible says the counsels of old, his counsels of old are what? Faithfulness and truth. God will never suffer his faithfulness to fail. How many glad that we are trusting a God that will always stand behind his word I thank God that when God speaks, amen, all we have to do is just what? Agree, amen, and affirm and say what God says and release our faith because, amen, we can ask in prayer, God will what? Answer. Amen. The scripture says, God has given us the use of his name. Jesus has given us the use of his name, right? And whatever we ask in Jesus' name, amen. Whatever we ask, everybody just say that. Whatever we ask in Jesus' name.
Whatever we ask in Jesus' name.
Amen. God, what? God will what? God will what? Give it you. How many believe that? How many really believe that whatever you ask in Jesus' name, the Father hears you, and he said he will what? Give it you. And Jesus said that whatever ye demand, amen. That's the power and authority that the believer has. Amen. When we become the righteousness of God, amen, not only are we restored back to God's, amen, we can come into the presence of God without a sense of, you know, fear or without a sense of what? Sin or unworthiness or, amen, you can come in God's presence without what? Without fear, without, amen, a sense of inferiority.
Yeah.
Amen. Because what? Amen. It's just as if you have never sinned. How many can say amen?
Amen.
That's what righteousness nets us. Now, the thing that I was about to say, the scripture says that we don't always have to ask in order to receive from God. We can what? We can call the things that be not as what though they are.
Yeah.
We can. What the Bible says that whatever we demand, amen, just say that whatever I demand, done in Jesus' name. You can demand Satan's power over your circumstances, what? Broken. How many believe you can do that? Jesus said you can speak to the what? Mountain. Amen. And what? Speak to that mountain and tell that mountain or situation to what? Move. And what? Don't doubt in your heart. Y'all help me to finish it out. But believe that those things that you what? Said, amen, shall come to pass. Jesus said you shall have whatever you what? You say. How many believe that you can have whatever you say? Whatever is demanded. You can decree a thing. Amen. Open your mouth and say, I can decree a thing. You know, sometimes we have a little problem about agreeing with God. Sometimes I can't say that. I don't pray as much as Sister Deborah. You know, I'm not, I never won a soul. How can I open my mouth and decree a thing? You know, sometimes people feel inferior regardless of what God says about them. They feel what that God's word is not true in their case. Y'all, amen. How many believe you're going to tell them the truth?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. But the scripture says, thou shalt what? Decree a thing.
Yeah.
Amen. And the thing that you decree, or the thing that you say shall come to pass. Amen. That thing shall be what? Established. Amen. I want you to say it with me. It shall be established.
I
decree a thing. Say that.
Amen.
You know, sometimes we are slow by saying. Is that right? We're kind of slow because, well, I can't get too bold before the devil because I never know what side I'll be end up falling on. But boldness and confidence, hallelujah, is the thing that right standing with God gives us.
Yeah.
We can decree a thing.
Yeah.
Just say it. I can decree a thing. You know, I don't hear a lot of people bold in their confessions talking like, I can decree a thing and the thing that I decree shall be established. Me and my Father are one.
Yeah. Yeah.
He that is joined unto the Lord are one. I'm saying, I can't hear you. I just put yourself out on a limb too far. But I believe that If Jesus names it, if the Word names it, we can what claim it? How many can say amen?
Amen.
If the Word, everybody say, if the Word names it.
If the Word names it.
I can claim it.
I can claim it.
Amen. Being that you decree, shall, not if, ands, and what may be, it shall be what? Established. Amen. I want you to say, it shall be established.
It shall be established.
And light shall shine on thy way, pathway. In other words, God will begin to what? Give you wisdom. When you begin to speak in agreement with God's word, wisdom always comes. Insight always results. On the screen of your imagination, God will begin to show you, amen, the end result. Oh, I'm just getting so happy now. Although you just, amen, the sun ain't shining. Y'all don't look excited, but I believe that if we would just praise God for what God says, I believe that things would turn out a whole lot better. How about you say amen? Praise God. Praise God. And I believe that's the key, amen, in bringing God's word or promises into fruition. If you begin to decree things, then God will begin to what? Show you. Wisdom will begin to what? Unfold just before your eyes. You begin to see the end. How many would like to see the end results of your faith on some things?
Amen.
We got 3 or 4 minutes. If you want to see the end results of your faith, amen, find the promise. Find it in the word, what God is offering you. Amen. And then you what? Begin to what? Agree. Say what God says about that thing. Amen. Now, if I would give, if I could pull out $100 bill and just offer to anybody that would make 5 or 10 confessions concerning who they are in Christ. Amen. Amen. Right now, how many would be willing to take me? The lady that got the $500,000 contract, she missed. All right. Now, this is the reason why I believe that going back to the Sanctified Church years ago, I was raised in the Sanctified Church, and sometimes people, okay, I'm supposed to be the light. Walk in the light as he is in the light. The blood of Jesus will cleanse us from our sin. I'm standing right here. All right. I think that what I learned in the Sanctified Church years ago really benefited me a whole lot in this respect. Because when I was in the Sanctified Church, this was the Church of God in Christ, I wasn't saved when I was until I was 21 years old, until I finished college. And just before I got married, I said, you know, I got saved. Wasn't that good? That worked out real well, because the day I got saved, amen, it was some manifestations of the Holy Spirit in the church, prophecy, and I was able to, what God spoke through me, I spoke to her, and she got saved with him with the Holy Ghost later. And then we got married, and we never lived happily ever. Amen. But in the Sanctified Church, I learned this, that you always, and they demanded that everybody doing, before the church service was over, usually the first part of the service, everybody testified. Y'all don't know anything about that, because if I would call on the average person to say anything, you would just always have a heart attack, and they get very nervous. Get very nervous. And that was the thing that taught the saints boldness and confidence. Every service, they would get up and do a scripture. Some of them would do a scripture, and some just simply testify, you know, being saved and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost. And that was fire. Some of them, you knew what they were going to say before they got up. Thank the Lord for being here. After being here, you find me, saved and sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost and fire, that they would, you know, they would, you know, they will do a little jerk. You know, that was, you know, that was the seal of that, that testimony, do that little jerk. And, but the thing about it is, it was the thing that caused them to be bold, because at every service, if you didn't testify, I think that maybe we need to go back to that, you know, to a certain degree, because you have people now don't ever say anything openly. They don't make any kind of confession as to what they believe. See, your confession kind of what locate what you're all about. It tells you where you are. And you let other people let them know where you are. That's the reason the scripture says, hold fast to your confession of faith without what? Wavering. Because he is what? Faithful. How many know that God is faithful? He's faithful that what? Promise. Faithful is he that calls. I wish somebody would just say that. And this is what I miss from the sanctified church. You know, sometimes when, you know, we call ourselves a word church. And I wonder about that. The word church. Glory. But you don't have people that habitually confess consistently what they are in Christ. It seems like people will always back down when they have the opportunity. Amen. To say what God says about what they are, what they are in Christ. And that was the thing. Now, how many remember, this is the thing that we are really believing for, because I think that we need to be bold. That's what right standing means. Bold, bold. You have to stand up to the devil. Amen. Y'all might criticize, but he's got a what? Big mouth. And he's what? Bold. And he won't back down. Even though he might be in the wrong. He don't what? Back down. And the testimonials were the thing that contributed to the boldness that many of them emphasized in the sanctified church. And I guarantee you, if we had a bunch of people from the Church of God in Christ, I guarantee you, they would out-sing you 100 to 1. I mean, when they open their mouth, they what? Let go and let God.
Yes.
See, she mentioned sanctified. You see how she opens her mouth and she rears back. Woo! That's the thing that I believe that we need to exude. Amen. We need what? More boldness. We need to what? Consistently affirm what God is to us. If he's greater than, the scripture says, greater is he that is in us. Amen. And he that is in the world. Amen. Amen. We need to what? Come into agreement. Now why they are so slow in agreeing with God? And making a whole lot of what? Fuss. Because the scripture says that we are to what? The New Testament, one thing teaches us, the Old Testament as well, that we need to what? Rejoice evermore. That everyone that seek him, let him what? Rejoice and be what? Glad. Amen. Everyone that seek God, Bible says let him rejoice and what? Be glad. Alright, everyone that seek the Lord, let them what?
Rejoice
and what?
Glad.
You see all these faces? Amen. Some of y'all have nice faces. Bless you. Some of y'all got smiley faces. Amen. But I believe a lot of us don't have smiley faces because of the Bible says God creates the fruit of your lips. And I believe that this is the key to overcome. The Bible says we overcome by the what? Amen. Christ has already what? Won the victory. How many have said Christ has already won? Say Christ has already won. Do I have to just You can pull it out of your Christ that's already won. This is the what? Victory. Whosoever is what? Born of God, whosoever is born of God, what? Overcometh the world. I want you to say that with me. Whosoever is born of God.
Whosoever is born of God.
Keep them over.
Overcometh the world.
Say it again.
Whosoever is born of God. Overcometh
the world. For this is the victory that what? Overcometh. Even our faith. Amen. Say it again. This is the victory. Say it. This is the what?
Victory.
What is the victory? This is the victory that overcomes even our what? Faith. And you know what faith is? Faith is what? Saying or confessing or affirming what you believe. If you believe, amen, you will speak. That's what the Bible teaches. If you believe, you will what? Speak. And how many can say amen? Praise God.
Amen.
How many can lift your hands and say, I and my Father.
I and my Father.
All right, Sister Neil, you say what? I and my what?
I and my Father.
All right, I want somebody to say, I and my Father.
I and my Father are one.
All right, what does that mean to you? I and my Father are one. It means that what? You're united. You're hooked up. Plugged in, right? You're inseparable. His strength is what? Your strength. His ability is your ability. You know, his what? Wisdom is what? My wisdom. Amen. How many remember the blood covenant teachings that inseparably connected the two persons that what went into that blood covenant agreement? In other words, amen. What was one's was the other's, right? Amen.
Amen.
How many can say amen?
Amen.
So that is the thing that's the reason why the teachings on righteousness mentions that whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. Why does a person become an overcomer? He overcomes sin. Overcomes what? Satan. Overcomes what? Your circumstances. Is that right? And you overcome what? The world. Amen. How many believe you actually become an overcomer when you get hooked up, when you get united, when you become one with Christ?
Yeah.
Now, I would be convinced. How many believe that you are an overcomer?
Yeah.
How many believe you are an overcomer?
Yeah.
Right now. I want you to say it right now. I want you to say it with your mouth. I am one. All right. Woo, glory. We overcome. How do we overcome? We overcome because of what Jesus has already what, done. We overcome because of what Jesus is what presently what doing. How many believe that Jesus is at the right hand of the Father right now? Working on your behalf. Yeah. Amen. How many of you said he's working for me? He's looking out for me.
Working
for me. How many have I heard O'Reilly say, I'm looking out for you? Well, Sister Hill don't trust O'Reilly. Y'all don't know who O'Reilly is. It's on Channel 52. Y'all don't watch 52. Glory! But that is true. Jesus is at the right hand of the Father right now, looking out for you. I want you to text somebody and say, Jesus is actually at the right hand of the Father. And he's what? He's... I want you to say that he's looking out for me. He's looking out for me. And if you are out of fellowship, he's operating. He wants to be your what? Advocate.
Yes.
I just feel like shouting.
Yes.
Oh man, can't run too fast, but I can see a press a little bit. Now suppose we just got really excited. You know, this is what Sister Deborah, we're going to pray about this. We just want people to really get excited about Jesus.
Yes, yes.
Amen. In this consecration, we want people to get what? Really, really, really excited about who? Jesus. You know, the testimony of Apostle Paul, Philippians 3:3, he said, we the circumcision, we worship God in the spirit. Y'all get it? We worship God in the what?
Spirit.
I want y'all to say it. In who? Jesus Christ. And we have no confidence in our flesh. I want you to repeat that with me. We the circumcision. I'm the circumcision. I'm the circumcision. We the circumcision. Come on, y'all say that. Y'all say that. This is the more confession y'all done probably in a month. But we're going to try to change that if we can. I believe that we can change it. Glory. I really want to change it because what happens is that when you begin to affirm things, then you are what? Placing yourself in a position where what? Your faith can work this time for you. And in order to get things into manifestation, you need to what? Affirm. Everybody say we need to affirm. We need to what? Say, come on y'all, say, we need to what? Say what God says.
Yes, amen.
I want you to say it again. We need to what? Say. How many believe that the power of life and death is in your tongue?
Yes.
Well, we need to start acting like it. You ready?
Yes.
Amen. The Bible says the mouth of an upright. I want you to repeat that with the mouth. How many have mouths? Amen. Guess what? I'll turn y'all loose and y'all go home and get on that phone. Amen. You have a lot of mouths there. The mouth of the upright. And I guess we have to try to teach these affirmations in our messages because it seems like that we don't, we don't want to. Yeah, some are really catching on. Just the other day, she said, I read that little brown book. She said, I'm halfway through. I'm making confessions right and left. I'm affirming it. And I'm praising God for the what? Fulfillment. For the man. Okay. You affirm and then you what? Praise God. That those that seek the Lord, let them what? Rejoice and be what? Glad. Let them say. Let them say. Just say, let them say.
Let them say.
Let them say.
Let them
say. Continually. Let the Lord. Ooh, I love that. Let the Lord. Let the Lord be magnified. How many want the Lord to be magnified? I want you to say, let the Lord. Let the Lord. Everybody just say, let the Lord. Say it again, let the Lord. How many want the Lord to be magnified? How many want the Lord to be magnified? Come on, say, Lord, magnify yourself through me. Magnify yourself. Amen. Let the Lord be what? Magnify.
Lord.
How many can lift your hands and say, let the Lord?
Let the Lord.
Say it again. Let the Lord.
Let the Lord.
Say it again. Let the Lord. Say it again. Let the Lord be magnified. Who had pleasure in the prosperity of his servant?
Yes.
How many can say amen?
Amen.
Well, I believe that the key is to what? Agree with God. Amen. I don't believe that you can come into agreement with nothing anymore. Amen. Authoritative. Amen. God's word is what? True. How many can say God's word? Jesus said, my word, sanctify them through my what? Truth. Say it again, sanctify them through thy what? Truth. For thy word is what? And how many know that truth, when acted on, can change? Can change what? Can change facts. I don't care what your circumstances are. Amen. How many got some circumstances you want to be, amen, you want to turn around? All right, everybody got a debate in here. Anybody got any circumstance that you won't turn around?
Yeah.
Come on, come on, come on, come on.
Yeah.
You know, they used to tell me you can tell a lie, you can what? You can act a lie. But I believe, glory, glory, that the truth, everybody says the truth.
The truth.
The Bible says if you continue in my what? Word. You shall what? Know the truth. Everybody said, you shall what? Know. And the what? Truth. Shall what? I want you to say that. The truth. Say it again. Say it again. I don't hear everybody say it again.
The truth set you free.
All right. Truth, when acted on, can change the facts. I don't care what your circumstances are. I don't care what your lacks and needs might be. Amen. I believe truth, when acted on, can what? Can change. Can change the what? The facts. You can be sick this moment, but you can be what? Well. How many know the truth can set you free?
Yes.
How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. So we want to do a revival of what? Affirming, we want to hold fast to whatever confession of faith, amen, that we are standing on without wavering. And we're going to praise God like heck.
Yes, glory.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Y'all quiet. The Bible says, fear not, O ye land, rejoice and be glad. Okay, I'm going to say it again. Fear not. All of this is in my meditation material. Now, I want y'all to start meditating this week, and I'm going to tell you exactly which pages are. Okay, fear not, O ye land, rejoice. Everybody say rejoice.
Rejoice.
Say it again, say fear not.
Fear
not. Don't be scared to open your mouth. I believe some saints are just afraid to what? Oh, if I open my mouth, I might what? I'm like, a demon might attack me. I don't know what they think. Some don't sing because they what? They fear their voices might what?
I don't know.
Their voices might be what hurt. The Bible says that the voice of your praise be what? Let it be heard. You got to what? You got to, how many of us say, let's tone it up? Come on, let's have me a tone. Come on, let's tone it up a little bit. Y'all want to tone it up a little bit so you can get more results? Come on, let's tone it. Y'all twist it a little. No. Come on, let's let the voice of your praise.
Hallelujah.
Let it be heard. I know some people would love to hear somebody say anything. Let me tone down. Why are we toning down? We scared to. I mean, not. Praise God too, but the devil might hear it. And he's the one that needs to hear it.
Yeah.
Amen. The righteous is as what? Bold as a lion. Amen. Set up with what? Flee when nobody is what? Pistol. But the righteous is as what? Bold. And a sign of your righteousness would be how bold you are in your confessions. And how bold you are in your what? Praise. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. This is what David said. I don't have all these scriptures at hand, but I got it in my book. I will talk of thy righteousness. I will talk of thy righteousness and of thy praise all day long. Y'all don't understand. I will talk. Amen. Open your mouth and say, I'll talk.
I will talk.
Amen. Amen. Can't they get your tongue, can you? Don't give me some tongues. Amen. Amen. I will talk. Everybody said, I'll talk.
I'll talk.
Of our righteousness. Come on, say, I will talk.
I'll talk.
Of our righteousness. and of thy praise. Do we have anything that's worthy of praise? Has God done anything that you can what? Praise Him. Well, from the rising of the sun. Somebody said, you ain't done that. But from the rising of the sun till the going down of the same. The name of the Lord. Everybody said the name of the Lord. Say it again. The name of the Lord shall be praised. Amen. How many are going to enter into a new cycle? Amen. That you're going to what? You're going to say what God said. And you know what? Praise Him like crazy. Yeah. Amen. How many believe that can get the promises moving in your direction? Yeah. How many believe? Hallelujah. Woo! Glory! The Bible says that we would only what delight ourselves in the what? Lord. He would what? Give us. Amen. God wants to do great things for us. How many can say amen? Amen. But He can't do it, amen, with your mouth what? Closed. He said, open your mouth what? Wide. And I will what? How many can say open your mouth what? Wide. How many really ready to turn, amen, to turn your praise knob a little bit? How many believe this thing is running a whole lot better than we want? We can see at this point. God wants the voice of your word praise. When God gives you a promise, He wants you to what, stand on that promise. And the best way I know to stand on it is just praising God like heck. Praise Him from the rising of the sun till the going of down of the same. God said, if you would just rejoice and fear not, but rejoice all ye land, I will do what? Great things. How many want to see God do great things? Hallelujah. Come on, say my kasara, kasara, kasara. How many want to see God do great things? He's a great God. And he has, the Bible says, I has a what? Neither ear has heard. Neither has it entered into the what? Heart of men, the things that God has well prepared. Woo, Lord. How many of those things are already ready? They're already ready for you to what? Turn the knob up. How many want to turn the knob up? The Lord wants to do what? Great things. He wants to do what? Great things. He wants to do what?
Great things.
That's the thing that got all these people excited about. He said, if I'm president, you're going to what? See what? Great. Glory. I'm looking on my God. God is able. Not just able, but He's what? He's willing. More than willing. He what? Delights in what? Mercy. He is full of what? Eager yearning. He wants to do it. And He wants to do it real bad. But He's just waiting for us to turn it off. Well, He's looking for words first, buddy. He can't work with nothing if you don't say nothing. Anyway, He told Daniel, I came for your work. Your words. That's what He told him. If you ain't got no words, God ain't got, He can't help you. He only can work with what you give Him. Amen. Some of y'all cut your arms, throw this, and that's enough of this. All right, come on, stay here. Come on, stay here. Woo! Glory! God wants the voice of your praise. Amen. Maybe y'all don't have no needs and no concerns. Everybody stand wherever you are.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. How many know that the promises of God are all in you? Amen. I want you to just repeat it. The promises of God.
Promises of God
are all in you.
All in you.
Amen.
Amen.
And know what I will. I want to do it. I delight in mercy. I want to do it. And I want to do it real bad. I'm full of eager yearning. Bible says his eyes running to and fro throughout the whole earth. He's looking for the heart that is what? Perfect before him. It's God's good pleasure. Everybody just say, it's God's good pleasure to give us the kingdom. Say it again. Say it again. Say it again. It's God's good pleasure. Say it again. God wants to give it to you more than you want.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. That's the reason why the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's what? Righteousness. It's what? Joy. Alright, the kingdom of God is not what? Meat and drink. But it is what? Righteousness. It's what? Peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. Everybody say it's righteous. That's what the kingdom is. It's righteous. Say it again. It's righteous. Tell somebody it's righteous. It's righteous. Then it's what? Peace. Everybody says that peace. How many want more of peace?
Yeah.
It's righteousness. I want you to say it with your mouth. We can tell we won't say nothing. It's what? The kingdom of God is what? Righteousness. Say it again. The kingdom of God is what? Righteousness. What else is it? And then is what?
Joy.
Woo, Lord. Y'all didn't hear that. It's what?
Joy.
Say it again. It's what?
Joy.
In the what?
Holy Ghost.
That's what Paul said. The circumcision they wish of God in the Spirit. They rejoice in Jesus Christ. And they have no confidence in the flesh. That's the reason why all through the New Testament you said, amen. Thanks, give thanks. Rejoice evermore. Rejoice. And again I say, what?
Rejoice.
How many want to turn it up? We're discussing Christian. You don't want to go through a hunger strike and not turning it up. You don't want to go through a hunger strike and don't say nothing. I mean, I fasted. You know, we used to say fasted, or now we say we eat fast. But this consecration, we just want to say we're going to try to get, not try, but this week it's just going to be a season of consecration. We're going to bring our little books, and we just want to just affirm until we get some life in us. David prayed, Lord, quicken me. According to your loving kindness. Quicken me. Make me alive. Quicken me according to your word. Quicken me. We need light. Bible says the gift of is what? Word giveth what? Light giveth understanding to the simple. This is where our life will come from. We'll never be the same if we feed on the word. That's quick with a diligent effort this week, each evening. Monday evening, I'm going to endeavor to be here at 6 o'clock, rather than 7, because I need a lot more time to pray so that I can pray. How many know you have to pray in order to be able to pray? Amen. 6 o'clock. Everybody just says 6 o'clock. Wednesday evening, we'll be here at 5:30, an hour before Bible study. We're going to be doing some real business. We're going to, amen, we're going to what? Let words come out of our mouth, because the only thing that's going to turn things around is the Word of God. The Word of God is life to them that want life. Everybody says the Word of God is what? Life. To them that what? In other words, friend, it means that what? You have to come in an agreement. You have to begin to what? Say what God says. And then you got to what? Praise God. In advance, offer the sacrifice of praise continually. Fruit of our lips, giving thanks to Him. That's the key. We want to push back our plates. Everybody said, push back the plates.
back in place.
Say it again.
Push back
the plate. Now, I'm almost tempted to say let's go without anything, but amen, maybe we'll just have fruits and vegetables. Then just fast, whatever y'all want to call it. Make it raw. And don't, put a whole lot of vegetables and cheese and vegetables and fat pork. Spicing it up, we just want to go with just what the straight stuff. Yeah. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
How many of you can do that?
Amen.
Three. Okay.
Amen.
All right. You can do salads. You can do fruit and vegetables. All right. Everybody, I got agreement with that. Say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And when man shall not live by what? Bread alone. But by what? Every word that proceeded. Every word that you can find that pertains to some provision or blessing that God has what is offering you, you want to what? Begin to what? Be offered. And we told you in the books, the prayer books, and also in the other books. Now those of you that are not here on Monday night and Wednesday night, how can we? We'll talk with you after church is over because we're trying to figure out how we can get all this information to you because we want everybody to be on the same page.
Yeah.
We're going to start distributing all of this. Of course, everybody on Monday night, Wednesday night, probably have everything. Just need to tell you exactly what the area that we're going to be focusing on. But we do have all this information. Amen. About ready. Let's say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Everybody that's not going to be here on Wednesday. Monday and Wednesday, we go into set a time that all of you can come and assemble, and that we can go over these. We're going to have all kinds of prayers for everything that we need to be praying about, especially our nation, political events that's happening now. We got all of these prayers lined up. We got all of these confessions lined up. And we believe that once we begin to speak this to God and begin to pray for our country, for our nation, for our political situation, I believe that God is going to turn some things around. But this is going to be the week that we're going to, even the second week, I'm considering some real straight fasting. I'm just going to let the Lord just do it a little bit of straight fasting. Amen. He'll give you some conduct water. That'll give you energy enough. All right. The second week. Well, we just deal with the first and third. Is that right? All right. Everybody's going to be here to praise the Lord. Father, we thank you for the word of God. Oh, the word of God will not return. Lord, everybody just say, it will return. Lord. Father, this week we're going to turn it up. Amen. I will praise for the nation, for the world, for missionaries, ambassadors all over the world. Amen. Sister Devon, you're going to be here. We need your prayers. Amen. You pray for all of this stuff. Amen. Real good. All right. But we want some words coming out of your mouth as part of the program. And we want some praise. Amen. So we're going to be here an hour before on Monday night, an hour before on Wednesday night. And I'm going to call Tuesday morning for the brothers. Thursday morning for the women. 5:00. 5:00. So do you like to check with you? All right. But we want to turn the knob up this week. We're going to turn the volume up. Amen. Father, in Jesus' name, we commit this consecration to you. Lord, we need it so bad. Oh, God, those that have done not even one of soul, those that even thinking about it, and all of the negligence that we see in the body of Christ, and people that need help that can't get it because we are focused on other things. Lord, let us just set our affection on things above and not on things of earth. Help us to come in agreement with your word across the board. Hallelujah. Help us to be concerned Lord, you say as I have loved you, so love ye one another. Lord, there is no way we can fulfill that command unless we are reaching out, amen, not just the community, not just in the city, but all the world, Lord, but reaching out among ourselves, so many within our grasp that need help, that never show up, that don't take the things of God seriously, that need somebody to speak into their lives, that need intercession, that need to hook up with somebody, so that they might be strengthened with might in the inner man. Father, help us to come closer, draw us closer. Draw us closer. Draw us closer. Draw us closer. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory in Jesus' name. Everybody just say in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Jesus' name. Everybody say, may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost rest and abide with us now, henceforth, and evermore. Everybody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.